Good evening, everyone. The Fred and Dinah Gretsch School of Music welcomes you to a celebration of Black composers. This concert serves many purposes, perhaps the most important of which is awareness. In recent words of William Brown, an African-American operatic tenor, access to the African-American composers using extended musical forms remains proportionally the same as it did in 1968. Brown questions, as many others do, how much we have actually changed as a society. While Black History Month has passed, Black history remains essential, and the Black struggle is still very much current. There is so much more to our story than slavery, segregation, and President Obama. Why Black composers specifically? It is because many people know the names of Beethoven, Haydn, Mozart, Chopin, Brahms, or even Eric Whitaker or Dan Forest. How many Black composers do you know? The absence of diverse programming tells people of color that art music isn't meant for them, and therefore that they don't belong in the audience. This is not the case. Our program tonight serves as an invitation to those who presume that the art we perform is not for them, to those who think that the music performed in spaces such as this is called white people music, or intended for those who are economically privileged. It is also an invitation to our traditional audience to explore the diverse and extensive catalog of music outside of the Eurocentric canon. While African American spirituals are the root of African American music, our concert shows that spirituals are not all there is to the story, something I myself have had to come to terms with as a young student in composition. We are allowed to write, to perform, to experience other styles while staying true to our past and our culture. With all things in mind, I hope you enjoy our program and silence all devices. Thank you.
again, thank you again for joining us this evening. We're excited to share these songs and the stories of the composers that come with it with you this evening. One of the special things that you might see tonight in collaboration with our choirs are some different conductors. We're honored to be able to share the podium with some of our undergraduate and graduate conductors in front of our collegiate ensembles tonight. And the next piece that you're going to hear is one of those pieces. So our next piece tonight is John 3:16. It's conducted by undergraduate music education and music composition major, Nehemiah Robertson. Thank you.
Oh. This young nobleman is about to meet up with her boyfriend, who is really a con artist. She doesn't know that yet, but she's starting to see some red flags. And she says, "Cruel fate! I feel like I'm on the edge of a cliff and I can't step back. But you're like a beam of light, oh my sweet Lionel. You make my heart sigh. Oh, I only want to look at you, and then I can die blessed. Everything bitter has turned sweet for me just because you sing to me. But what if I'm dreaming? What if you're a liar or a creepster even? No, your mouth is too beautiful to lie to me. You're too beautiful to betray me. You couldn't be lying."
Thank you. director of opera here at GSU. I'm very excited that we are part of this and get to do this scene for you tonight. If you will come with me to be transported to the French Market in New Orleans in the late 19th century, you are going to see diva opera singer Manette stumble upon the shop of Marie Portier the Great asking for help. I'm very excited because we have five fantastic singers in the scene today, and making his directorial debut, student Caleb Wims has directed this scene. So without further ado, in just a few moments, as we transport you to New Orleans, I really hope you enjoy I Knew You Were Coming from Manette Fontaine by William Brent Still. Thank you so much. In just a few minutes.
Thank you. Oh, My soul's been anchored in the Lord. joining us this evening on this special concert. This last piece is actually a premiere. As you know, Southern Chorale competed last summer in Berlin, and we posted a lot of those videos to our YouTube channel, Georgia Southern Choirs. And the composer of one of the pieces contacted us and asked if he could write a piece for us. So we're very excited tonight to premiere a piece by Stacy V. Gibbs, I Go to the Rock. And actually, he wrote it for Amari because he heard Amari sing Getaway Jordan on that video. So this is kind of special to have him sing this with us tonight. We're going to be professionally videoing this after a few more tweaks in a couple of weeks. So you're going to want to watch that YouTube channel to see the final video soon. Thank you so much.
In the time of tribulation.